So I've gone to Kingsway, and I really like this mission. I don't know why people don't. This is a really fun mission, and it does take a while to get used to, but it's just fun. And as a Ventrue, there's no problem with blood. There's, if you have high defense, there's no problem with blood. And I just think this is really a good time. I've been looking forward to this the whole game. Another great view. Okay, the primary weapon now is going to be the axe. The axe does more damage, and I take less damage, and you can't take any chances here. And the spaz is weapon number two. I'm going to use fortitude, probably not anything else. Get the axe ready, because as soon as we come in the building, there's a fight. I don't waste any bullets on headrunners. I usually don't waste bullets on people either. They're not worth the price of the bullet. And no trinkets for me to pick up. Not in this room. And this is the room where the girl died, and that's the corner where she died. That guy always makes me jump for some reason. And on the table is a special item, an occult power-up. Increases passive healing rate by 25%. That's good. Looking at other special items we have, decreases the chance of frenzy. Plus one to dexterity. That's the gargoyle thing. And blood buff now has twice the duration. Passive disciplines increased, what was that, 100? I think it's actually 150% they seem to increase. And we got a plus one to defense for the other thing that we have. I'm just going after these guys. Another blood pack and another blue blood pack. Neither one of which will we probably ever use. And we still have the two elder packs. Play so many different versions of this game, it's hard to remember where all the knickknacks are. Yeah, I know there's nothing in here. Okay, now I'm gonna get ready for a fight, and what I need for the fight, this fight, is the automatic shotgun. And I want to save this just in case.
Hello, young K-Knight. I see your face is not so lifeless. Your nerves not so deadened that you cannot express shock. Tell me, child, is my appearance that frightening? Or is it my knowledge of you that is so unnerving? Oh, child of Cain. The sights in this haven pale in comparison to my ancestral estate. Comfort is a custom, and all of this artifice brings me closer to my home. Do not fear for my furniture, young one. Oh yes, the tape. Merely a test. Certainly not intended to fall into mortal hands. Fortunately, we are in the capital of mortal trickery and illusion. So did the tape drive you to find me? From whence flows your longing, child? To gouge out the eyes of the Camarilla. The sewers are clogged with my creations. I will kill or drive the Nosferatu from their pestilent nests. Without the sewer rats to guide them, the Camarilla will be blind to the Sabbat's designs. It is not for me. It's for the will of the Sabbat. The Camarilla is stunted, dead and festering in the womb. Good only as pawns of the fathers. Even now, they answer the call of the ancient and seek to free him from his torpor. He slumbers within the Ankaran sarcophagus, one of the fathers whose return shall hearken the reckoning. Kuhena is at hand, and the Camarilla are unwittingly speeding us all toward our doom.
Finally.
Now, Camarilla whelp, let me see you fight your nature in the face of those who have embraced their beast. Deny yourself Cain's gifts and be torn asunder by my minions.
Everyone talks so big in this game, and I have the automatic shotgun. So here we are, and I knew this guy would come up pretty close. And he loses half his life. Those guys are annoying. I'm moving around so he doesn't do that much damage. Just trying to... I'm not going to do anything over there. There he is. Oh, and I missed him. And enough of these guys. I need to hit him one more time. He's done. And this guy's done. And that's all there is to it. He's just up and dead. And that's it. Empty two volleys into the guy, and then pound the little headrunners with the axe. And that's that easy. And lots of rats to feed on for everybody but me. I love that atmospheric music. I'm just going to mention that was in Buffy the Vampire Slayer. I'm just going to mention that. I don't know who does it, but it's great. And I'm using the shotgun because the ammo is absolutely free. I didn't pay for the shotgun, I didn't pay for the ammo. And this is one of those cases where I'm shooting a fish in a barrel. That's pretty much the only reason I kept the shotgun and didn't sell it, so I could do stuff like that with it. Oh look, more rats. I'm staying crouched down. It gives me a better defense and better control, and the headrunners do less damage to me if I'm crouched down. They're easier to kill. They seem to have a harder time with me. This is why I said I have too much spaz ammo. I knew this was coming. And this gives you a resupply of everything you have. And yep. But there's a way around that. Create some space. And I think I've picked up two journals or ledgers or something, and they're interesting to read. Think down to the right, the way I didn't go is a way back to the surface, or the room we were just in with the ledger, that's a way back to the surface. I'm not really sure where the other one is. I never take either one. I never go back to the surface. I'm saving the game just in case. This is a simple exercise, but it can go very badly here. If you don't catch the ladder, and I have missed it a couple of times, not very frequently, but a couple of times. If you miss the ladder, you're going into the spinning blades and you're gonna die. So I always save the game so I don't have to replay from like the beginning of the mission. These things are pretty easy to kill while they're in the tube. They kind of announce they're attacking with the sound, and you just pound them. Okay, here's a fun little trick that I learned from watching other people play. Yeah, he died. The 1-2 over is too far away for the Glock, so we have to bring out the heavy guns. And what happens is he falls into the water, and we'll see him in a little bit. And I always save before I jump, because if you go into the water, well, you might die. And there they are. This is where the shotgun has value, because they can't really do anything but stay there and die. And I paid absolutely nothing for this ammo, so I can fire all of it. Quick save before I make the jump. I learned this trick from watching a walkthrough, and I wish I could remember who did this. The person I learned this from, you know who you are if you're watching this. Absolutely great fun. What I'm trying to do is turn one of these barrels over on its side. It's a little bit difficult. They don't want to go, and they tend to want to collapse. But I take the first barrel, and I throw it into the spinning blades here to lock them up, and then I can go through, climb up on top of that and go through the tube on top, and that's great. But then you have to fight your way all the way down to the left until you get to a walkway. Well, there's a shortcut. And I'm trying to do that now, and that is go back to the other, where we came from, and shut down the other spinning wheel and climb up there. And I screwed that up, so I have one more barrel. Fortunately, this is not a video about game mechanics. This is about how to get all the experience points possible and the order to do the missions in to get the greatest ramped up character you can get, the most powerful character, and the most money. Every single player of this game is better at game mechanics than I am. So, it worked. It may be ugly, but it worked. And now we're going in through the left one. Now, there is a guy waiting, a headrunner waiting on us, but that's okay. Now, if you've played this, you know you don't fire a gun out here, because if you fire a weapon, one shot, all of the headrunners in all of the tubes come after you, and there are a bunch of them. But here's something that I found, because I have high sneaking, is that instead of going around to the left, the other side over there, and there's another headrunner over across the way, I go through the way I just went and skip that. And instead of running down the walkway and then fighting all the way back, the hole I want to jump into is right beneath me right now. So I'm just going to jump down to that hole right now. And I don't need to fight the guy in that tube. There's a headrunner in each tube. I can do that and skip all of that. So instead of fighting a whole bunch of headrunners all the way around, I can just do it that way and skip all the fights. And go on with my day. Okay, and a quick save. These guys are target practice. And I'm killing them because I know I'm gonna miss the jump to the other side and I'm gonna have to climb up that ladder. And I just assume they're dead on the other side. I make this jump successfully 1 time out of 10, maybe. Yeah, I jumped too soon. So, and then I just run up the ladder, and that's fine. And because I killed those guys, I don't have to fight them. Okay, I want to jump over there. I kind of know the spot. And I throw this until the lights come on, and then I throw it back from left to right. I want to save the game so that when I miss the first couple of jumps, I don't have to climb back up and do it again. Yeah, and there's the first try. And that's way too slow. That isn't going to work at all. So that's what you don't do. Complete waste of time. Got hung up. No chance whatsoever. I want to show you what it looks like if you take just a moment too long, and that's where you go. You go there, and then go backwards. Okay, that one looks good. So I was probably trying to jump too diagonally previously, and I try to do that for some reason when I pretty much have to just jump straight. And that should be close enough. I think I made it. Can push a couple of inches, just barely. And now we're on our way. There's a right and a left turn. It doesn't really matter if you go the wrong way. Get misoriented, and it doesn't matter. You'll come to a dead end and just turn around and go back the other way. I'm thinking right now about I have too much spaz ammo. Usually I kill this next guy with a 44, but I need to get rid of some spaz ammo. I have another resupply point coming up, and if I don't get rid of some, it'd be like wasting. So instead of standing back and just firing from a distance and easily killing this next monster, I'm going to run up to him and put the spaz, the automatic shotgun, into his belly button and pull the trigger. Yeah, you're scary. How about that automatic shotgun? And I got rid of, I made way. I got rid of six bullets, one magazine, which is good because it's going to get replenished. Okay, there's a drainage spout thing with green goo coming out of it. That's the one time you turn uphill. Pretty much you're headed down. You're headed downhill all the time. That's the one kind of upturn. The other one is Tunnel 33. That's all I have to remember when I go through is I see 33. Tunnel 33, that's my turn up. These next creatures really hate the spaz, and what will happen is, if you don't have the automatic shotgun, they come right over to you and hit you. But if you have the spaz, they don't want to come over to you. And normally I kill this thing with the 44 as well, because it'll stand far away from me. Yeah, you're screwed. It'll stand far away from me and throw bodies at me, and I can kill it easily with a few rounds of the 44. But again, I want to get rid of some spaz ammo, so I'm going to run up to it and kill it at close range. It's going to throw something at me, and I really don't care. It doesn't do that much damage. I, on the other hand, do a lot of damage. Okay, I was hoping for maybe two magazines of that, but okay. I don't have to throw the barrels out of the way. I can walk through them. I can jump. I can't jump very well, but I can jump across that little gap there and just ignore the monster. And I've watched people do that, and I've done it. I tend to trip over the bodies, mistime the jump, fall into the ravine, and die. But if I do that, I don't get the ammo. And I want the ammo that's in the box. That ammo has value. Okay, I'm saving. Although really, if I missed completely and would go all the way down, it probably turns out to be about exactly what's gonna happen anyway with me making some jumps and missing. How did I miss the ladder? Yeah, I've fallen the entire distance, and I don't think I've ever died. You just get really, really, really hurt. And I got really hurt there. Okay. I'm gonna just wait a while and let that recover.